I just recorded two relatively complicated, in-depth, difficult-to-record videos, and I thought that I would do something fun and ridiculous for this next video. And this is Stupid constexpr Tricks, and it requires knowing a surprising number of little corners of the languages to understand why this compiles at all. Although, for some of you, you might have just expected it to compile, and for others of you, you'll be completely surprised that it does compile. Well, anyhow, before I carry on, I do need to remind you that I am available for code reviews and on-site training, and I really do love doing training, and I am happy to travel to pretty much anywhere in the world, and I know that your coworkers need my training, so you should contact me about getting training at your organization. If that's not an option, then on October 10th of 2024, I do have this Applied constexpr workshop at C++ Under the Sea in Breda, Netherlands. You should come to that. Or if you happen to live slightly further north, or you're interested in visiting Norway, then you should come to my NDC Tech Town C++ Best Practices workshop on September 9th and 10th of 2024. This is my Stupid constexpr Tricks video. Let's just start with this. This isn't terribly surprising or confusing in any way. I have a constexpr function that returns value. Now, you're probably going to be surprised that this static assert compiles, because this requires a compile time known constant to compile. It's kind of as if I had done something like this also requires a compile time known constant, but now I've got this unused variable thing, so let's just get rid of that. Now I have another const. It is not constexpr, and I am still able to static assert on it. And I am still able to static assert on this, and this should really surprise you. So there's two different rules coming into play here, and one is a rule that is quite old that says a const integral that is initialized, so that is this const auto. I've hidden the fact that it's an integral from you, but it is because I'm returning the value 42, which is of type int here, so this is an int, so this is a const integral that has been initialized by a constant expression. Make value is a constant expression, is itself a constant expression. So value is implicitly constexpr. Interesting. I don't recommend that you rely on this feature, but it's definitely interesting to know. Now, following the same rule, x is an integral, 10, that was initialized by a constant expression, and that's quite a bit more obvious here because 10 is literally a literal that's literally in the code, which is a constant expression, which is an expression that's, you know, kind of known at compile time kind of thing, which is what constexpr means. It's a portmanteau of constant expression. So x is an integral that is const, that is initialized with a constant expression, and is therefore itself a constant expression. Okay, we've got that out of the way. Now the next one should be particularly surprising to you. It's the fact that I can reference x and value inside of this lambda that has no captures. Well, it turns out that you don't actually need to capture constant expressions in lambdas for them to be usable in the lambda. That's interesting and surprising, but this works on every compiler, so I am able to reference x and value. And then this thing also doesn't say constexpr anywhere, but it turns out that lambdas are implicitly constexpr if they can be, as of C++ 17. So this is a constexpr function that references constexpr values implicitly, even though these things were never labeled as constexpr values. And that means that result itself is again implicitly a constant expression. And therefore, I am able to static assert on this entire nonsense, and this code does exactly what we would expect it to do. or what we didn't expect it to do, because it was surprising. And this is Weird constexpr Tricks. So thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I don't really necessarily recommend that you rely on any of these things, but just so you know, if I do try to explicitly capture these things, depending on compiler and settings, I might actually get a warning here. Note in Clang, capture of X is not required to be captured for this use case. It says it's an unused capture, which is weird because I'm clearly using it, but it doesn't explain to me the rule for why I don't need to capture it. Anyhow, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe and leave a comment. And I'll catch you in the next episode.